people might be wondering what Flash is all about here. So Flash for us is an acronym that we created, which kind of reflects what the talent acquisition industry and HR in general is undergoing, right? And this is a platform that we are, which is a future ready, low touch, so which basically means eliminate as much of manual human interactions in between through the process as much as possible. AI-led, AI is the buzzword, and I think it's a huge, huge potential for HR and recruitment in general because of the tons of data that we create in at every stage of the process. Socially, locally, mobile solutions. So we are social, we use the power of networks. Please. Right, so we are Solomo-enabled hiring. So this is Flash. So what I will do in the next 20 minutes is take you through certain things that's happening in the HR industry, some of the challenges that we see are coming out from our discussions with various HR leaders, and our view of how some of the things are going to change in the near future, and these are not very futuristic. The pace of technology is so high today that anything that you consider as today as will happen 5 years in the future suddenly is at your doorstep in about a year or so. So that's how it's going to be. So we'll start with a quick video. Oops. Can I just come in? Okay, sure, sorry, no problem. So what challenges can we expect as we are looking at growing our companies in 2018 and beyond, right? It's a world that's constantly evolving, bunch of things getting thrown at us every day. Technology obsolescence is a constant, right? Things in the past, someone knew Java, you thought your life was secure for the next 20 years. Today you know Java, you're just at the basic building block of doing a technology career, like you wrote a bunch of stuff. Even in hiring, in the past, you used to hire for Java, you used to hire for .NET. Those days are gone. You don't hire for Java anymore. You hire for a bunch of technologies. You hire for full stack. You need people with like 10 different things in their accomplishment today, right? So things are changing, and so are the challenges for HR as well. What are the three key vectors that you're looking at? First vector is the industry shift itself. I think this is an important thing that we need to look at. By industry shift, we are looking at shift to an open talent economy. It's reality today. As late as 6 months ago, 1 year ago, people were saying that this is a fanciful idea. There's nothing called the gig economy. It'll all die down. You read the reports in the US today, and it's coming to India as well. Gig is real. Millennials like to do gigs. They're not coming in for a 30-year-old career or a 20-year-old career. Right? We didn't do it for them. I mean, in our cases itself, we're looking at 2, 3 years or 4 years, and people have jumped jobs every 3 years, 4 years, which our previous generations would balk at, saying that how can you keep changing jobs so frequently? But here they're doing by design. They're saying that I'm available for 4 months. I'm available for 6 months. Right? I have a bunch of skills. What can you do with me for 6 months? That's what the millennial is all about. After 6 months, I don't even know where I want to go. I'm going to take a break. I'm going to do some other things. So that's the entire thing that is driving the gig economy in the US, right? So which is a huge paradigm shift from the way we used to hire. So you're not hiring for someone to be here with you for 6 years. You're hiring for someone who is anywhere likely to be with you only for 6 months. So therefore, your processes has to change. Can you spend 2 months trying to hire that guy? Obviously not, right? So that's one. Hiring manager driven, and this is happening because many hiring managers today, and again, everything is chronological, right? In the past, we had the luxury of lack of a more apolitical word, throwing warm bodies at jobs. So we had the luxury of doing it. As wages have gone up, as prices have gone up, as costs have gone up, that luxury doesn't exist anymore. You need to get everyone right there, right time. Every hiring manager needs to get, there's no cushioning window for someone saying that there is a 1 month induction period or a 2 month warm up period. He can get trained. After that, he'll be deployable, etc. He has to be deployable from right from day one. He has to make it count from day one. So that's the entire thing about, and because of that, the hiring manager says, look, I need to have a much greater say in who I'm hiring, right? I can't just leave it to, it's not about leaving, but I can't stay away from the decision making. I have to be there at every stage of the decision making process. And the last, of course, the Solomo mobile-first users, right? Everything in this world that we do, almost everything today from morning till night, is centered around this one particular piece of equipment. This has revolutionized everything for us. So everything from medical care to everything. I mean, Apple has watched, has launched the new version of its iWatch. And it says it's an FDA-approved ECG reader. Can you beat that? I mean, this is like technology taking, you know, all over the place. So we are covered in technology. And if you tell someone that, look, you know, for your process of getting into my company, we can't allow you to take it on an assessment, but, you know, can you go to a laptop or a desktop or a testing center, which we have 30 kilometers away from you? Can you sit there and do your assessment or evaluation? The guys are going to say, sorry, boss, I have got enough stuff to do. And I'm anyway looking at something for 6 months, right? I don't want to be spending 30 kilometers in one week trying to get to place, et cetera. So this is the industry shift. So are we ready for it? The second are constants, right? There is always the pressure of saying that, can we get an accurate and efficient hiring? We can't afford a wrong cost of a wrong hire, right? Can we get the guy get it right the first time? We are looking at, so therefore there's a pressure to find the right fit. And right fit today, as I said just a little while ago, is not about just skills. It's about the overall person that you're employing, right? The bigger shift that's happening because of, as we say, the industrial revolution number four is actually the age of the automaton, which basically means that a bunch of stuff that, if you're going to hire only for skills, the chances are that you're going to make a wrong hire because that skill will ultimately get taken over by an automated process. You need to hire a person who can deliver or show the ability to learn a bunch of skills, connect with other humans, connect with machines, and work together in a collaborative environment. Those are the key things that you will see there, right? And finally, the threats. Complex jobs. I spoke about saying that you don't hire for Java or .NET alone anymore. You need to hire for a bunch of other things, right? So the jobs are very complex. There's a war for talent, and that's because the number of resources that are available that possess all this is limited. You might have a large population of 1.3 billion, for example, in India and whatever else in the rest of the world, but the number of people who will fit your job is very limited, and the bigger challenge is this particular person might be anywhere, any part of the globe. He doesn't necessarily have to be in the locality where you have your office or in the city where you have your office. So these are all threats that are there. Attrition continues to be an issue, and with the millennials coming in and gig economy being the big driver, attrition is like almost a standard there. You can't even call it attrition anymore. It is a design process. And requirement for new job skills, you know, you've got to constantly refresh your assessments, your measurement platforms, because the requirements keep changing. Your JDs are not constant even for 1 year today. In the past, you make a JD, if you look at 8-10 years ago, people used to make JD and then they used to change the JD only 2-3 years later. Look at changing it. Today, you need to change it as early as 6 months, 3 months. Things are changing constantly. Roles are getting evolved, right? So some stats. Many of the stats you might have looked at. 92% of millennials want to work remotely, and this is true. I mean, it's just not about the distances that they have to travel from home to office, etc. They would like to work in at their pace, at their comfort, at home or any other place that they want, that, but obviously with deliverables in mind. But they would want to work remotely, and this is a statistic that is thrown at us constantly. Teams are therefore going virtual. So if they're working remotely, that's an opportunity as well. It's not just a threat. The opportunity is that your next hire that you're trying to replace for a person in your office could be in a city that's 5,000 miles away, right? Now, if that is the case, can you continue with the process of having a not virtually enabled hiring platform? And that's what we're going to talk about. 78, and multi-channel hiring, right? Now, there's no, again, going back in time, we used to have consultants who used to hire for you, and that's probably one particular source. Then it evolved into internal job postings, referrals, so on and so forth. Now you're using multiple platforms. You're using Facebook, you're using LinkedIn, you're going all over the place because you don't know where the next hire is. And many of the new platforms are all virtual. They're not physical. So therefore, you have to get virtually enabled there. Geographies, we kind of touched upon this in the previous slide as well. You hire from multiple geographies. Your challenges are not from hiring one region. Gone are the days when you just go to a consultant location, there are 20 people lined up for you and just do a quick hiring and come back. The 20 that you hire or that you look at today would be in 10 different parts of the globe, right? So that's reality. So let's look at some of the other things that are happening and that are likely to happen, predicted by people that are constantly watching. By 2025, and nothing, 2025 is just like 6 years from now, 75% of the workforce is millennial. And millennials, as we just discussed, bring with them a new set of expectations and expectations, I wouldn't call them challenges, but which are challenges for the talent acquisition industry. We spoke about some of the points there, right? It takes an average, and these are all numbers that are there, it takes an average of about 52 days for many companies to fill positions, and these are at higher levels, not necessarily at the entry level where you have little more abundance of talent, but you go one step higher, two steps higher, you get, this is the average number of days. So if you know that the person that you're hiring is likely to stay with you for 6 months or 8 months or 9 months, would you have the luxury of taking 52 days to fill that position? The answer is no. So you've got to be able to do it much faster, right? The number of days a good candidate is available when he decides to move on is about 10 days. Phones here. So let's look at the other side of the spectrum, on the candidate side. There's a bunch of experiences the candidates are facing and they're expecting also, which is all fine. This is a generation of Instagram where people want instant fulfillment of stuff. They don't want to wait and say, I will wait 10 days to figure out my next stage of my interview. Absolutely not. I mean, you got to possibly tell him within 1 hour. You can't tell him after 10 days, right? Google, for example, famously used to hire with about 12 stages of recruitment process lasting almost a month, right? That was in 2006. If Google tries to replicate that today, they might still pull it off because of their brand, but highly unlikely that they will get all the candidates that they would have got 10 years ago. So that's the change that is there. Many job seekers have had a bad experience. And bad experience can range from longer time to hire, too many processes, etc. The problem which is bigger for companies is from a branding perspective is that all these guys are going on social media and putting it up there, right? Oh, this threat didn't exist 3, 4, 5 years ago, right? Today, any negative experience, forget job, you have a bad experience with the Swiggy delivery, your mobile is available with you, you immediately go and post a negative rating. You have a problem with the cab, you're immediately posting it. Why wouldn't you post about a bad experience on a job? You go to a hotel, you have a bad experience with something very simple, very, very small. In the past, you would have just gone and spoken to the desk manager and given him some feedback at best. Today, you would have posted it even before you checked out of the hotel. And multiple such ratings affect your brand ultimately. So can you allow that to happen, right? So these are some of the stuff. And I think all of these ultimately converge in saying that there is a need, and it is happening before us in terms of how things are changing. Right? There is a significant change that's getting driven. Let's look at the talent supply chain in a sense. Right? The recruitment technology stack is broken. Why is it broken? And these are steps all of you are aware of. There's nothing much to explain in each of these stages. You have ATSs. You have Talview. You have SuccessFactors, etc. Many of these today, for lack of a proper word, are actually fairly outdated and glorified databases. Talview doesn't do anything beyond. They were great at one time. At one point of time, they were brilliant. But today, with the extent of change expected in the talent assessment process or talent acquisition process, Talview just doesn't work, number one. Number two, many companies, I think, because there wasn't a unified one single platform in front of you, you bought in some best practices across. You had one assessment partner, you had a screening partner, you had a selection partner, you had an onboarding partner, you had different process. Data, typically only the ones that move from one stage to another are that of the final employee. So you finally have some data about final employees, which also doesn't really move across system very seamlessly. Now, moving of data between systems seamlessly is helpful in 3 or 4 different ways. Most important is that with the advent of machine learning technologies, and if it's all available in one system, there's a lot of learning that gets passed from the downstream process to upstream, and ultimately leads to what is an utopian talent acquisition state, which is predictive hiring. Can you predict and hire someone before the hiring requisition hits you? Can you get to a position where you can tell, you can line up your candidates and be ready because you know that the hiring requisition is going to come hit you tomorrow? Can I have 5 candidates ready already? Right? If you have to reach that stage, you will have to reach that stage. Predictive hiring is the only way to go. And for that to happen, you need to have data that moves right across, left and right, with feedback all across coming in. Right? As I said, the feedback process makes the recruitment process smarter. We are already doing it at Talview. We help companies do this with data that comes from performance. We are able to build it back into our AI-enabled engine to improve your screening parameters. So screening becomes more and more faster, more and more accurate. You're able to get the right resume from a big bundle of resumes with far lesser effort if this data process works. Right? So in summary, to meet all these challenges that we're looking at, we need to modernize HR. There is no other option. HR traditionally, until about the last 3 years ago, has been slow in adopting technology. Today, I think HR has been at the forefront of getting newer technologies coming in, right? What are some of the early results of adopting technology? And when I say early results, I'm not talking of someone who just tried in the last few months, but technology adoption in the last 2-3 years. People have reported high operational efficiency, increased operational efficiency, improved internal external collaboration, because it's all available virtually, it's available across platforms, data moving across all over the place. Far more collaborative hiring, collaborative talent acquisition processes with high operational efficiency is what we are looking at using this. So if you look at the two screens, this is how we used to do as hiring traditionally. We used to have a multi-layer, multi-filter approach to from moving from resumes to the offer, right? This is moving fast. We are moving to the world of Insta hiring today. In Insta hiring, there have to be multiple processes that happen parallelly. It's not sequential, it is parallel. It is happening as we speak. Candidate walks into a store, sees an ad for a company, has a barcode, scans it on his mobile, quick immediate questions, first screening done, candidate decides to proceed or not immediately, something's thrown at him, it could be an assessment, it could be a video interview. All of this is happening as he moves from the mall back to his home. And by the time he reaches home, he's probably reached a stage where both the company and the candidate know where this is headed. Right? This is how things will move, because this is how things are today. Everything wants everyone on the go, on mobiles, and instantly. So from having a multi-step process, we are going to a parallel evaluation, anytime, anywhere kind of scenario. Right? Instant screening, instant selection is what you're looking at. What this will lead to, what Insta hiring can lead to, is to move from months to offer to ultimately, one could call it utopian today, but with technology and with advancements today, that can become, which can become reality, is hours to offer. From the time a position is opened, within hours can the position be offered and filled? That is the utopian state we can reach with the adoption of the right technology. So what do we do at Talview? Talview is an Insta hiring platform. We help end-to-end virtual recruiting. So every stage can be done completely virtually, whether it is asynchronous video interviews, live interviews, assessments on the go on the mobile, talking to candidates, everything can be done completely virtually. You don't need the candidate to come to your office and line up in a queue. Because there is data being captured at every stage of the process and is adding to the building of the profile, we are able to create a completely comprehensive profile. In fact, I'll talk a little bit about one of the tools in the next slide as well. Because we are using all this data, you get far more refined and decision-ready profiles when it hits you. You don't have to think saying that, oh, should I look at this, should I look at this, can I look at this, etc. For example, you could be hiring someone and you find that the candidate doesn't meet the requirement for that role. If you have all the data available across the system automatically points the candidate to another role that is available. It could be in another geography, it could be another center, it could be another role completely, and say, you are fit for this role, do you want to try this? That fungibility can happen on the Talview platform. Right? Predictive hiring, we have a deep engagement analytics engine which really goes and digs deep into the data. This gets built, obviously this doesn't come on day one. As we engage with companies, as we get more and more data, we're able to build data models to ensure that, you know, your hiring becomes more and more accurate, more and more predictive, and much, much, much faster. So we spoke about it. intelligent sourcing, instant screening, a data-driven solution process, offer, and streamlined onboarding. All of this is significantly possible, some of which are with on a platform, partner platforms. We do partner with onboarding solutions. We do partner with ATSs. We do partner with other assessment solutions. We have our own assessment engine. We also connect with people like Pearson. Pearson is a partner on assessments. Meritrack is a partner in assessments. Kenexa is a partner in assessments. IKM is a partner in assessments. So all of these are partners with us. We have our own assessment platform as well. This is one of the stuff that I spoke about, which will give you deeper data into your hiring. This is behavioral insights based on the video interview. You had the traditional way of measuring personality, which was using a situation judgment test or a 16PF kind of a scenario, which is an extra test. What we do is slightly different. We use something called as psycholinguistics. Psycholinguistics is it's an older branch of science, except that it's got funneled into the mainstream because of the advent of technologies, advent of computing power like that of the Watson analytics engine, and of course a bunch of stuff, APIs from the Microsoft side as well. We take an interview, and the interview could be about absolutely anything. So we are not going to use the interview specifically to hire behavior. It could be a technical interview, it could be an interview about what the candidate did in the previous job, whatever. We use the kind of words that the candidate used and put the psycholinguistics framework on top of it, which essentially says that as a behavior, as a personality, you are what you speak. What you speak is reflective of your personality, and what your personality is sometimes is developed based on how you speak and how you interact with people, right? And there's a science behind it, and that's psycholinguistics. And we use the words that the candidate speak, and we are able to build a behavioral profile for the particular job based on that. So what it does is two things. Uses a far more cutting-edge way of measuring behavior. Second, it uses a video interview which could be rated for content accuracy by your raters. You could say that technology, 10 questions of technology were asked, candidate answers that, a rater could rate saying that he's right on this. Parallelly, the words that he uses is also measuring behavior. So there are two things happening at one shot, right? So we use all of this. We use tone analysis. We use emotion recognition. We use a bunch of inputs in the video to create the behavioral profile of the candidate. And this is successfully being used for customers. ZS is a big customer of this entire behavioral profiling. We've got more than, across our customers today, 150,000 data points of video interviews that we have done. And these are all not free-for-all trial interviews. These are actual interviews used by the customers to hire the final people. Right? We've also been able to help some of our customers showcase their practices. We won the best HR system project for 2017. A leading bank used our process for predictive hiring, and they were able to get this award. They have been able to optimize the process significantly in terms of hiring as well. And predictive hiring, and we spoke a little bit about it. I won't dwell much on it now. Where we see the predictive talent supply chain happening is exactly like this. You have talent supply analytics and talent acquisition. You've got a bunch of data from various existing scenarios about existing employees, candidates that have shown interest in applying, and you profile them. These are warm candidates available. You might have candidates internal that is there. You might have candidates internally, but who need to get trained and who can trigger a requirement to the L&D team saying that, hey, here's a candidate who is at 80% level for certain roles in this organization. We believe from predictive analytics that role could be opening up in the next 2 months. Do you want to train this guy now? So that kind of tunes your L&D organization much, much more sharply. And using all these sources, because all of this data is available on one single platform. It's not on three different, there's no separate L&D engine, there's no separate talent acquisition engine, there's no separate screening engine, there's no separate ATS. It's all on just one single platform, data flowing seamlessly between these various steps. And because there's an analytics engine sitting on top of it, we are able to predict this and help you make these decisions much faster. What this will lead to, and I'm going to conclude with this, is we are seeing a significant change in the way talent is being hired. And if you were to just look at a timeline, this is not just our vision, but I think this is reality, is that we will move from offer in months, which is present state, in 2018, but we will move to offer in hours with Insta hiring on Talview. This is obviously a process, but we believe the starting of this is already happening. And ultimately, the utopian state of time to offer being zero, which is predictive hiring. Right? You virtually will have your next hire right there when a position becomes vacant, rather than actually having to wait for a 2 month or a 3 month period. So this movement from months to zero seems to be a very steep movement, but we believe this will happen in 3 to 4 years at best. And 3 to 4 years is where we'll reach stable, mature state for this. We are not going to start off with time to offer being zero in 4 years, but we'll have that as a business as usual case, right? That's pretty much what I wanted to quickly kind of cover in this session.